Hello. My name is Treya Killam Wilber. A lot of you have known me in the past as Terry. I've been involved with Windstar from the early days. 5 years ago this same month, in August of 83, I met and totally fell in love with Ken Wilber. I always called it love at first touch. We were married less than 4 months later, but 10 days after our wedding, I was diagnosed with stage 2 breast cancer. We spent our honeymoon in the hospital. I've had two local recurrences and a number of treatments, both conventional and alternative, in the intervening years. But just this January, we discovered that the cancer had metastasized, that it had spread to my brain and to my lungs. The doctors we've consulted have said I have 2 to 4 years to live. So when Tommy asked me to speak tonight, my first thought was, but I'm still sick. You know, the other people who are going to speak have in some way overcome the challenges in their life or have crafted something of use from the difficulties. You'll hear from Mitchell, an old friend of mine, later this evening. Well, I thought, okay, I'm still sick. Maybe I can look at what I've done with my life since the diagnosis. I've counseled hundreds of people over the phone and in person. I co-founded a place in San Francisco called the Cancer Support Community, which now provides a wide range of free services for hundreds of people each week. I've written as honestly as I can about my experiences in a way that many say they have found helpful and hope to publish a book soon. But when I got to the list, the end of this list of doing, I thought, oh, I've fallen into an old familiar trap. I'm equating success with physical healing against all odds or with concrete accomplishments in the world. I feel instead that the shift in perspective that we're here to celebrate tonight is an inner change, an inner choice. I find that for me, this takes the form of the spiritual work that I do each day. And I'm very eclectic. I draw on all traditions. I'll read anybody. But if I don't do this, if I don't take the time to do this, I find that my situation very quickly becomes frightening or depressing or sometimes even boring. While if I maintain this work each day, I find myself continually engaged by life, continually excited and challenged by this incredible situation that I'm in. If I maintain this work, the emotional roller coaster of advanced cancer becomes for me a chance to practice both equanimity in a true sense, at the same time that I find my passion for life increasing. Learning to make friends with cancer, learning to make friends with the possibility of an early and perhaps painful death, has taught me a great deal about making friends with myself as I am, and a great deal about making friends with life as it is. I know there are a lot of things I can't change. I can't force life to make sense or to be fair. This growing acceptance of life as it is, with all the sorrow, the pain, the suffering and the tragedy, has brought me a kind of peace. I find that I feel ever more connected with all beings who suffer in a really genuine way, and I find a more open sense of compassion, and I find an ever steadier desire to help in whatever way I can. There's an old saying, it's popular among people with cancer, that goes, life is terminal. In a way, I'm lucky, because I've been given advance warning, and I've been given time to take advantage of that advance warning. I always notice how old people are when they die. I always notice newspaper articles about young people who die in accidents. In fact, I used to cut these articles out. Because I could no longer ignore death, I pay more attention to life.